We found three opinions. What is considered Pat Haba Bekisonin? What does it mean, Pat Haba Bekisonin? It means something that you would say, the Bracha Mezonot, over the Bracha of Hamotzi. So you have a piece that looks like bread. Sometimes it's bread, sometimes it's Mezonot. Pat Haba Bekisonin. What is it? The Gemara says that you'll say on such Pat Haba Bekisonin, Bore Minei Mezonot. So, what is the definition of Pat Haba Bekisonin that you'll say the Bracha Mezonot? Says the Tur. The Tur brings three opinions in the Rishonim. Pat she'asui kemin kisim meleim sukar veshkedim ve'egozin u'minei tavlin mevarech alav bore minei mezonot u'lachareha bracha achat me'en shalosh. In those opinions, that opinion, also the other opinions, come down l'alacha in the Shulchan Aruch. In Siman Kuf Samech Chet, Seif Vav, the Shulchan Aruch says, Pat Haba Bekisonin, Mevarech Alav Bore Minei Mezonot.
What is it?
Ulacharav, Bracha Achat Me'en Shalosh, you say, Al HaMichya afterwards. V'im Achal Me'eno Shiur Sh'Achirim Regilim Likvo Alav Seuda, you would make on such a thing Hamotzi. What is it exactly that you would say that is defined as Pat Haba Bekisonin? Says the Shulchan Aruch, Pat Haba Bekisonin, yesh mefarshim pat she'asui kemin kisim shememalim otam vasho sukar vegozim ushkedim vetavlin. This is the opinion that we saw before in the Tur, and this is the perush of Rabbeinu Hananel and the Aruch as well, besides what the Tur brought down. Yesh omrim, second opinion, she'isa she'erav badvash o shemen o chalav o minei tavlin vafa. You took the dough and you put in it milk or oil or honey. That's the second opinion. That's the opinion of the Rambam. And this is what we'll have the shiur today on that opinion, so pay attention. So we had the first opinion that the two brought down, which is pat she'memalim ota dvash o sukar, which means you take something and you make it like pockets. That's why it's called ba bekisanin. It's like a kiss. Kisanin, it's like a pocket. Kisanin. So therefore, you have something, let's say, as we would have hamantaschen. Right. So it's dough, and inside you have in it jelly. That's called pat haba bekisonin. You'll say on such a thing, bore minei mezonot. The perush of the Rambam that we'll concentrate on today is you made the dough with some oil, some milk, or honey, or other things, or minet tavlin ve'afa, you'll say on such a thing, bore minei mezonot. And the third opinion is, yesh mevarshim, that's the aruch b'shem Rav Hai, pat ben metubelet, ben shana metubelet, shosim otam ke'en, ke'achin yeveshim ve'kosesim otam. Which means you have crackers. When you buy crackers, let's say you buy kake, what is it made of? It's flour and water. So why is it mezonot? You should make on kake hamotzi. The answer is, it's crackers. Something that's crunchy, that's like crackery, you'll say on such a thing, bore minei mezonot. How was it decided what should get the bracha of mezonot and what should get the bracha of hamotzi? It was decided by that factor of how do you eat that thing that you have in front of you. Do you eat it as a meal or do you eat it as a snack? People take bread, pita, and so on, and eat it as a meal. That's why it's hamotzi lechem min haaretz. And people that usually eat those things that we mentioned, whether it's hamantaschen and the like, or it's something that has in it sweet things, like let's say milk in the dough, honey in the dough, you'll have a cake, a sponge cake. A sponge cake has in it chocolate and other minei tavlinim. You'll say on those, mezonot. Why? Because people eat that as a snack or dessert. They don't make a meal. You don't take a sponge cake and you say, okay, that I'm going to have today for my lunch. People usually don't do that. And the third thing is the kake that we mentioned. Whatever is crunchy, people usually don't eat that as a meal. Those are the three opinions. The Shulchan Aruch says on all those opinions, although it's machlokot Rishonim, as we just explained, but in the end of the day, there's opinions that some say that it would be he would be mezonot, and Shulchan Aruch concludes, as the Bet Yosef, as he brings down in the Bet Yosef, l'inan alacha, kevan shespeka b'midi d'rabananu, naktinan k'divrei kulam le'akel. Since it's a safek, so, and it's a safek b'derabanan, so you go like all of them le'akel, and you say, borei mine mezonot and not hamotzi. The Bach asks the question, he doesn't understand, but you, in the end of the day, what do you mean le'akel? If you end up saying mezonot on something that's hamotzi, you're saying bracha, that's not correct. Could be it's a bracha levatala. That's the question that the Bach has. There's many answers to the Bach question. I'm just pointing out that the Lashon of the Shulchan Aruch is a little bit hard to understand. L'inyan halacha, k'man shesfeka b'midi d'rabananu. Since it's a safek in the Rabbanan, so you go lekula, you say mezonot. Why mezonot is a kula? Where's the kula in it? Why saying mezonot defined as a leniency? Okay, question of the Bach. There are answers, few answers that's brought down. Maybe we'll touch on it. I just want to mention, I mentioned that purposely, this idea of the conclusion of the Bet Yosef Lahalacha, that whenever you have a safek amotzi, safek mezonot, you say mezonot. Coming back to our discussion right now, the question I want to present to you is, what happens if you have a piece of bread or a pita that has in it majority of juice? Today they have all kind of pita that they write on the package, it's 2/3 apple juice, 1/3 water. So since it's 2/3 apple juice, the birkato mezonot. So is it really mezonot, or should we say on this hamotzi? The package says it's mezonot. What does the halacha say? Let's go back to the opinion of the Rambam, because this is the question, goes under the category of the Rambam. It's not something that's crunchy. It's not something that is pockets. Rather, it's a pita. It's a pita that has in it majority of juice. So let's read what the Rambam says. Let's read how the Shulchan Aruch says. We'll speak maybe on egg matzah. Egg matzah is a big sugiya by itself, but you're right. Egg matzah. Matzah is a sugiya by itself. Egg matzah, yes, it's mezonot because of that reason that you said. You're right. Matzah is a big sugiya. Egg matzah, you're right. Regardless, it would be mezonot because it has in it eggs and it's tavlin, meorav, badva, shemen, and so on. Oh, that's exactly what we're talking about right now. So let's see how the Shulchan Aruch brings those things. Let's see how the Bet Yosef brings it. I'm reading you now. Let's read first the Shulchan Aruch because it's more easy, and then we'll go into the Bet Yosef. The Shulchan Aruch says the following. I didn't say those words before. I want to mention them now. The condition in the Shulchan Aruch. Yesh omrim, what's Pat Haba Bekisonin? Yesh omrim she isa she'erav badvash o shemen o chalav o mine tavlin v'afar. You took the dough and you put in it, you added to that tavlinim, honey, sugar, whatever it is, you added to that. Says the Shulchan Aruch, he adds a condition that's not written. This is the Rambam's words. But then he adds something that the Rambam didn't say. What is it? Vehu she'yet tam ta'arovet ameh perot ha'tavlim nikar ba'isa. It has to be visible in the dough, which means when you eat it, you have to be able to feel it's sweet. Once you feel it's sweet, it has a changed taste, then it's mezonot. And that's why Sfaradim are very lenient with those things, that whenever you have something that has a little bit sweetness, you have a roll, it's a little bit sweet, mezonot. Many Sfaradim have that leniency based on this Shulchan Aruch. The Rama argues on that. The Rama says that Yesh omrim shezeh nikra pat gamur. Even if it's a little bit sweet, it's considered pat gamur. It's considered bread. Ela im ken yesh behem arbe tavlin o dvash kemine metika shekorim lekich, shekimat hadvash vatavlin memikar vechen noagim. Rama says that you need to have majority, arbe, a lot of tavlin, dvash, mine metika. Now there's a machloket over here, what exactly needs to be the lashon of the Rama, shekimat hadvash vatavlin emikar. It needs to be that that's the majority, that's the ikar, that's the main thing over here. What is it? The thing that causes it to be sweet. That's the opinion of the Rama. What does it mean ikar? Does it mean ikar that you have to have majority of tavlinim and juice, like our case, for instance, of the pita that has 2/3 of apple juice? That's what the Rama means, that you'll say mezonot? or it means that you have to feel it. It has to be strong enough that it would be felt. And this is how it's brought down in some of the Achronim. The Taz writes, צריך שיהיה בה הרבה תבלין או דבש ומיעוטו מים, שכמעט הדבש והתבלין הם עיקר דהיינו מצד הטעם. It needs to be the flavor, the taste, and not that the majority of the substance there is the sweet thing. Okay? So this is the Rema. So based on that, we have a machlok at Shulchan Aruch and the Rema. According to Shulchan Aruch, you'll take an egg challah. It's a little bit sweet. It's problematic. It's a big sugiya. Can you say, can Sfaradim say, Hamotzi on egg challah on Shabbat? There are opinions that hold that yes. Take a look at Rav Moshe Levi in Birkat Hashem. That's how he brings down that you eat the egg challah, you eat more than kabeitza. Kabeitza is double kazait. Kazait is 27 grams. So this you have over here, double that. That's a motzi already. So others say, no, mezonot is mezonot. That's a chidush of Rav Moshe Levi. Others say, pashtut, mezonot is mezonot, unless you eat kashiur kviat tzuda. What's shiur kviat tzuda? Kik machloket as well. According to Sfaradim Minag, you need to eat 8 bitzim. Some say 6 bitzim, some say 8 bitzim. Machloket rishonim. Lemaise, you're eating, let's say, 213 grams of 230. Depends how you calculate. Chaim Ovadia says 213. Ben Ishchai, 230 grams of that challah. You'll have to say hamotzi on such a thing. We want to come back to our discussion. Our discussion is, you have over here pita that's two-thirds apple juice. What would you say on this? So the Shulchan Aruch said, the Lashon of the Shulchan Aruch, if you remember, said, Vehu sheyeh nikar ba'isa. Vehu sheyeh tam ta'arovet ameh perot ha'tavlin nikar ba'isa. You have to feel it. So if you don't feel it, it stays what? Hamotzi. It doesn't change into mezonot. That's how, one minute, we'll touch on everything. I just want to present to you the way to read the Shulchan Aruch. This could that mean also that if you have something that's 100%, there's no water. Let's say you have pita that was made with 100% apple juice. And just dull apple juice that you don't feel the taste of the sweetness of the apple juice. And you have over here 100% of that juice made into the pita. Would you say that pita now is hamotzi? Because Shulchan Aruch says that in order for it to become mezonot, you have to feel it in the door. And you don't feel it. If you don't feel it, it's hamotzi. That's how some of the poskim want to say. This is how Harav David Yosef brings down in Halacha Brura. This is how Rav Moshe Levi brings down in Birkat Hashem. This is how they want to say that the minhag is as well. That's what they want to say, the opinion of the Shulchan Aruch. But it's not so simple to say it that way. Why not? Because when you read the Shulchan Aruch, first of all, you can argue very simple that it means that when there's a majority water and minority juice, that is Shiyeh Nikar Ba'isa. If you have a large amount of that, that stays mezonot. It could be that's the Lashon that the Mishnah Bura brings down. On the Rema, hechasher rava be'alisha rak me'at dvash v'chalav, v'no batel shem pat mechamat shenirgash atam. So we're dealing over here with a minority of that tavlin, honey, or so on. The Shulchan Aruch himself, in the Bet Yosef, brings that openly and clearly. That's how he's talking. Let's see the Shulchan Aruch inside, in the Bet Yosef. The Bet Yosef is the introduction to the Shulchan Aruch. That's how he structured and built up the Shulchan Aruch. He first brought the whole discussion, and after he had the whole discussion, he brought the conclusion to the Shulchan Aruch. So he brings the Rambam. But pay attention. Let's read the Rambam carefully. Ve'arambam katav, pergimen milachot b'chot alachat et, she'isa she'nilosha bedvash, o b'shemen, o b'chalav, o she'rei b'minei tavlin v'afa. What is Pat Haba Bekisonin? What is mezonot? You took dough, and you put in it other things, that made it apparently, well, he doesn't say made it, he didn't say any of that. You put in it honey, oil, milk, or mine tavlinin, all kinds of spices. Says the Bet Yosef, Ashulchan Aruch, he goes and tries to understand the Rambam. Haya nira lomar, on the first glance, you understand, Ve'ainu dafka shelo natan mayim ela me'at. Could be, when is it mezonot? Only if you put a little bit water. But the majority, like the Rama wants to say, majority is juice. The majority is other things. Aval im natan b'mayim arbe, but if you put a large amount of water and just a little bit of juice, afagav shenatan b'gam sh'ar mashkim, kivan shemiyut aninu, telim em legabe amayim. Since you put a little bit of juice, let's say you put a third apple juice and two-thirds water, so the third apple juice has the same status as the water. It's batel. It's nullified to the water. We considered everything to be water. It's 100% water because the third loses its name, apple juice. That is, before we get to that, we're building this up. We'll get to that question in the end of this understanding of the Bet Yosef. But first, just we're building this up. The Bet Yosef just asked the question, what is the Rambam talking about? I want to bring the Rambam la'alacha in the Shulchan Aruch. What is he talking about? He's talking about, when is it mezonot? When it's majority juice or minority juice? In the beginning, he tries to say that maybe the Rambam is talking, it's majority juice. It's majority juice, I can write down in the Shulchan Aruch, that's mezonot. And that could be the opinion of the Rama. But the Rambam is, but the Bet Yosef rejects that opinion. And he says like this, Ela, shemima shekatav yirev b'minei tavlin, since the Rambam adds over here in other words, and he says, you added some tavlin, yirev b'minei tavlin, you added a little bit spice, you added some spices, ikalemeida kipcha, you can say the opposite. And that's the conclusion of the Bet Yosef, that tarovet tavlin davar muatu, we have a little bit of spices here in this dough, which will make mezonot. And it doesn't have a status anymore of bread. And you don't say motzi on it. We don't care what's the name lechem in other places generally. אלא לא קבו לברך המוציא ושלוש ברכות אפילו כזית, אלא בלחם שדרך אדם לקבוע עליו סעודה. דהיינו, עיסה שנילושה במים לבד, בלי שום תערובת. זה איזה conclusion to Bet Yosef. When do you say המוציא? Only if it's such bread that you don't add any other spices in it, anything in it, no juice, no honey, no spices, nothing. Then it's המוציא. אבל כל שיש בה שום תערובת ממי פירות, if it's something of מי פירות, of juice, או מתבלין, כיוון שאין דרך בני אדם לקבוע עליו סעודה, לא חייבו לברך המוציא ושלוש ברכות. חכמים established that that should be, if you added some juice to it, they established that that should be mezonot. And this is how it's posek in Shulchan Aruch, in Kuf Samech Chet, in Seif Zayin, that is mezonot. But he adds to that, in the end, the words that we pointed out before into the Shulchan Aruch. He says, והוא שיהיה טעם התערובת ניכר בעיסה, דומיה שירב במיני תבלין שטעמם ניכר בעיסה. וזה נראה עיקר. Which means, when do you say mezonot? Even if you have just a little bit juice in it. But you must feel that juice. You must be able to taste it. And this is how the Kaf HaChaim learns the Bet Yosef, because you could get confused in the Bet Yosef. If anybody has different ways of learning the Bet Yosef, take a look in the Kaf HaChaim. It brings it exactly the way I read it right now. So I'm just saying, pay attention very well. I'm saying that over here you see that in the Shulchan Aruch that even though you have minority of juice, but you have to feel it.
Right.
What if you have majority of juice? Then it doesn't need that requirement of being of needing to taste it.
I don't feel it.
Okay, another question. I want to concentrate on our sugiya. You hear what I'm saying? Pay attention again. When you have, the Shulchan Aruch says if you have a bread, you have pita, that has in it a little bit of tavlin, a little bit of apple juice, it's mezonot, as long as you feel it, you can taste it. But it comes out from the Shulchan Aruch that that's the only time that you'll say such a thing. If you have a majority of juice, on that he didn't say that you have to feel it. He says as long as there's something there and you feel it. Now, obviously you can argue with what I'm saying and say, no, maybe it means on everything. But you'll have a problem with the Rama, the understanding in the Shulchan Aruch. Pay attention to what the Rama says. And the Rama is very important because this is a machloket that you find by Sfaradim and Ashkenazim always. What falls under the category of Amotzi? Says the Darkei Moshe, the Rama. Darkei Moshe is the Rama. He brings it afterwards to Halacha and the Rama. אבל אין לו מנהג כדבריו. The מנהג is not like the שולחן ערוך. שהרי בשבתות וימים טובים נסורים מברכים ומוציא על מיני לחם ומתובלים הרבה. We make המוציא even if it's very sweet, he says. וניכר בהם במראה ובטעם. And you can, and it's visible in the look and in the taste that it's so sweet. על כן נראה שסביר את זה לא יצא מכלל לחם, במה שירב בו תבלין או שאר משקין מעט. That's what he argues on the שולחן ערוך. If you added a little bit sweetness to it, nothing happens to it. It doesn't change the status of Hamotzi, according to Shulchan Aruch. If you added a little bit, it changes the status. Water? Because?
It's mostly water still.
Because it's mostly water, yeah. אלא אם כן, עיקר העיסה נלוש באותם דברים, ואפשר שגם דעת הרמב״ם כן, לא כפירוש שפירש הבית יוסף. מקום מקום נראה לי שאותם מיני מתיקה שקוראים לקח, דינם כדין פעד הבא בקסינים, שרש בהם הרבה דבש ופסמים, ועיקר העיסה נלוש בהם. Comes out like this. The Rama understanding in the Shulchan Aruch, that what are we talking about when we're saying that you added over here תבלין, יש אומרים שעיסה שרב בדבש או שמן או חלב או מיני תבלין והפעה, that is מזונות. We're talking that you added a little bit. Just like the Shulchan Aruch wrote himself in the Bet Yosef. The Rama reinforces it. He says, what the Shulchan Aruch says, that you added a little bit, is incorrect. But you see that he understood that this is what the Shulchan Aruch says. That you only added a little bit. And on that, the Shulchan Aruch says, you have to fill it. But he doesn't talk about a case that it's majority juice. Do you have to fill it? Because on that, it seems very clearly that that should be already definitely mezonot, even if you don't feel it. This is the opinion of the Marsham. Marsham was a huge posek, kadmon from the Ashkenazim, that says that if you have majority Jews, it stays mezonot, it doesn't change to become a motzi. You have majority Jews, even if it's a non-nikar, even if you don't feel it. This is how it's brought down as well in the Da'at Torah, the Agaon Mibarajan, he says like this, מה שכתב השולחן ערוך שיהיה טעם תערובת המי פירות ניכר בעיסה, נראה לי היינו שאם היה רוב מים, אבל ברוב מי פירות אין צריך שיורגש טעם המי פירות. You don't need to feel it. This is how the Shla brings down as well. This is how you can read in few of the poskim. Now, we said that there are those that want to learn that if you have majority of juice inside the pita, 2/3 apple juice, and you don't feel it, should say amotzi. We said that's the that's what the Halacha Brura brings. That's what Rav Moshe Levi brings. This is how some poskei zmanenu want to bring. But lechol hayoter, it should be a machloket over here, right? It should be a safek what the Shulchan Aruch brings down. Let's say you could argue to say that the way I read the Shulchan Aruch, you can read it a little bit differently. And you can say that, no, the Shulchan Aruch pointed out this, but it didn't come to exclude the case that it's majority juice. Majority juice should also, you need to feel the taste. Could be, you could argue that way, and this is what they say. But what happens if you have something that's debatable, what the Shulchan Aruch means? Or you have something that's a machloket aposkim. If you have something that's machloket aposkim, whether it's mezonot or amotzi, what's the halacha? What should you do? Mezonot or amotzi?
Amotzi.
Do what?
Says
the Shulchan Aruch, he taught us that halacha. Le'inyan halacha, kevan shesfeka b'midi d'rabanan, u'naktinan k'divrei kulam le'akel. And you'll say mezonot. Which means, even if you say that, you know what? What I'm saying, it's not proven. Maybe yes, maybe no. You can't say that I'm totally wrong, the way I learned, because I have g'dolei olam that say the way I was saying, the Marsham was a huge posek. He says that in the opinion of the Shulchan Aruch. I just mentioned to you and I read to you that the Da'at Torah openly says that way. You can argue that the Ben Ish Chai says that way as well, because he doesn't say that it needs to be Nikar Ba'isa. So there are those that learned, like I'm saying. And let's say there's a second way, which I don't hear, But let's say there is a second way, the way the Halacha Brura says, that he wants to say that it says over here one thing and it's like broad. Even if it's 100% Jews, it needs to be Nikar Beisa. Let's say he's right. I don't understand what he's saying. But let's say he's right. But at least it's debatable. If it's debatable, the Shulchan Aruch told us that the halacha should be whether it's safek hamotzi or safek mezonot, you make mezonot. And you have questions. How could you say mezonot? How is it kula? Maybe it's a wrong bracha. I told you. The poskim asked this question. And the Bach asked this question. And the achronim, after the Bach, come to explain how this works. And there's arichut on this. Many want to say that mezonot covers pharmacy as well. Many say other answers. We're not going into that. All I want to say are my conclusion over here is one, that when you have that kind of pita, that's two-thirds apple juice, by the way, which was approved by the Rabbanut in Israel, the Badatz in Israel, that it should be written on it, by Landau and others, that it should be signed on it, on the package, at Birkato, Birkat Mezonot. In other words, it's a big machloket. When you have such a thing, when it comes lemaaseh in the end of the day, if you are a Talmid, or and you go like the Psakim always, of Rav David Yosef, hey, make on this amotzi. But if you more want to see what the poskim tell us, you're not bound to one posek, you want to see what overall the poskim tell us, so you have over here two ways of learning this. And again, I'm saying my understanding, there's only one way of learning this. But at least you'll see over here different ways in the poskim. They understand it in different ways. So if they do, you have over here what is called the machloket, or at least it would be a safek how to learn the Shulchan Aruch in the Bet Yosef. And because of that, whenever you have a safek, concludes the Shulchan Aruch, l'inan alcha, kevan de sfeka b'midid rabananu, naktinan kedivrei kulam leakel, and you'll always say on this, mezonot. Questions?
Hey, Robert, sometimes you don't have time. You know there's hamashim. You know it's hamashim because of the machloket.
Right.
But still you go and say mezonot.
Because you don't have time. Look, I want to tell you something. Now it's almost 8 o'clock, and I don't have time. I want to eat already. So because of that, I still don't cut corners. What should I do? Another question. Chavod, you had a question. It was answered?
Yeah.
Questions, Chavod. Right. It depends who's machloket. There's the machloket I was talking about. First of all, let's summarize. You have three opinions in the Rishonim. What's Pat Haba Bekisonin that you'll make on it? Mezonot. Shulchan Aruch says that we'll take all those opinions la halacha, and you say on the mezonot. On something that the Rambam's talking about, that has in the dough some sweetness, says the Shulchan Aruch, as long as there's a little bit sweetness, that's nikar, you can feel it, you say mezonot. Rema says, no, it needs to be majority, it needs to be ikar. That's it. I was presenting a new question. What about the opposite? You have something that's majority Jews, but you don't feel it. Or 100% Jews, but you don't feel it. That the Shulchan Aruch didn't speak. And on that we had the whole discussion. On that we found to have a machloket poskim. And I'm just concluding, whenever there's a machloket poskim, or whenever there's a safek in halacha, the conclusion should be mezonot to such a thing.
So basically,